So, our first question: consider the following statements regarding Harappan civilization. So, Harappan civilization. So, we have all the cities in Harappan civilization. All the cities were divided into two or more more parts. So, those more parts divide the. Okay, it's correct. And it is in the divided cities. Usually, the part of the west was larger, but at the lower elevation and called as the lower town. In the divided cities, usually the part of the west was part of the west was larger and was larger, but at lower elevation and called the lower town. In the divided cities, usually the part of the east was smaller. In a divided city, usually the part of the east was smaller, and but at the higher elevation and called the as the citadel. So all are correct. Consider the following statements. Consider the following diseases. So, which of the following above diseases are caused by protozoa? So, malaria. It is caused by protozoa. It's correct. And hepatitis B. It's not by protozoa. And dysentery. It is caused by protozoa. So, यहाँ पर देखिए malaria is a mosquito-borne infections disease affecting humans and other animals caused by parasitic protozoa. So, a group of single called microorganisms belonging to the Clostridium type, malaria is a life-threatening disease caused by parasitic and transmitted to the people through the seeds or the bites of infected female Anopheles mosquito. And dysentery is the correct, but hepatitis B is not correct. And hepatitis B is a viral infection, attacks the liver and can cause both acute and chronic disease. The virus gets transmitted through contact with the blood and other body fluids of an infected person. As estimated, 275 to 57 million people are living with the hepatitis B virus infected, and it is not correct. So it is a viral infection and chronic disease, both acute and chronic disease. So the virus gets transmitted through contact with the blood and other body fluids of an infected person. An estimated 257 million people are living with hepatitis B. And dysentery is a blood diarrhea, and that is any diarrheal episode in which the loose or voluntary stools contain visible red blood. Dysentery is most often caused by Shigella species, bacillary dysentery, or Entamoeba, histolytica, amoebic dysentery. It is caused by several types of infections, such as bacteria, virus, and parasitic worms and protozoa. The terms shark, aphids, and bugs ground are related to which geographical phenomena? Shark, aphids, and bugs ground are related to landform and glaciation phenomena. Okay, to which geographical phenomena? It is landforms of glaciation, not coastal landforms, not others. Okay, so a shark is an amphitheatre-like valley formed by glacial erosion. An arete is a narrow. It is a narrow ridge of rock which separates two valleys. It is typically formed when two glaciers erode parallel U-shaped valleys. Bergschrund are crevices at the junction of a glacier or snowfield with a steep upper slope. So with a steep upper slope, this includes landforms of glaciation. Which of the following is the most appropriate description of species? So here for similar organism having the potential for interbreeding and producing fertile offspring. So here for C is the correct. Which of the following is the most appropriate description of species? So similar organism having the potential for interbreeding and producing fertile offspring. So assemblage of products, plants, assemblage of population, plants, animals, bacteria, fungi live in an area and interact with each other is called biological community. If a community of animals and plants inhabiting a particular area are also known as population, similar organisms having the potential of interbreeding and producing fertile offspring are called species. Statement D is a genetic statement. So group of organisms co-dependent on each other for survival. D is not correct. And A, the assemblage of production plants, population plants, plants, animals, and fungi that live in an area and interact with each other. It's not correct. And the community. So यहाँ पर बोल रहा है species के बारे में appropriate description of species. So most appropriate. And B देखिए, a community of animal population inhabiting in a particular area. It's not correct. But C is correct. Similar organism having the potential for interbreeding and producing fertile offspring. Okay, so it's correct. Next question. The Indian Constitution provides certain fundamental rights only to the citizen, only to the citizens, whereas certain fundamental rights are provided to citizens as well as foreigners. In this regard, which of the following fundamental rights are available to both citizens and foreigners? So Article 20. So both it's these fundamental rights are available to both and both for citizens and foreigners. Article 20 and Article 21A and Article 19 is not correct. And Article 22 it's correct, and Article 25 both foreigners and citizens. So just two is not just three. Three is not here correct, but Article 1, 2, and 4, 5 it's correct. Because Article 19 guarantees to all citizens the right to freedom of speech and expression, right to assemblage peacefully and without arms, right to form associations or unions or cooperative societies, right to move freely throughout the territory of India, right to reside and settle in any part of the territory of India, and right to practice any profession or to carry on any occupation, trade and/or business. It is available only to citizens, not foreigners. So Article 19 is not correct, but Article 20 is correct. It provides protection in respect of convictions for offence. Both citizens and foreigners enjoy these fundamental rights. It's correct. And Article 21A declares the states shall provide free and compulsory education to all children within the age of 6 to 14 years in such a manner as the state may determine. It is also available to both citizens and foreigners. So it's correct. And free and compulsory education to all children between age of 6 to 14. And Article 22 provides protection against arrest and detention in certain cases. It is bo available both foreigners and citizens. So it provides protection against arrest and detention in certain cases. And Article 25 guarantees freedom of conscience and free profession, practice, and propagation of religion. So Article 25 guarantees freedom of conscience and free profession, practice, and propagation of religion. It is available to both citizens and foreigners. Foreigners do not include enemy aliens. Aliens. यहाँ पर आपको थोड़ा सा याद रखना है, foreigners को enemy aliens नहीं होना चाहिए. So Article 22 provide protection against arrest, detention in certain cases. And Article 25 freedom of conscience and free profession, practice, and propagation of religion. It is only available to both citizens and foreigners, but enemy not enemy allies. Okay, next question. When a constitutional amendment aims and modify aims to modify an article related to the distribution of powers between central states and the union government. Then which of the following type of majority is required to amend the constitution? तो जो है ना कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल अमेंडमेंट, जो कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल अमेंडमेंट जब इसका क्या है ना एम्स टू मॉडिफाई करेगा आर्टिकल को रिलेटेड टू द डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन करेगा पावर्स को बिटवीन द स्टेट्स एंड यूनियन गवर्नमेंट कर दिन व्हिच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग टाइप्स ऑफ मेजर इज ऑफ टाइप्स ऑफ मेजोरिटी इज रिक्वायर्ड टू अमेंड द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन. सो यहाँ पर स्पेशल मेजोरिटी ऑफ द इन द पार्लियामेंट विद रेटिफिकेशन बट नॉट लेस देन. तो यहाँ पर पार्लियामेंट में स्पेशल मेजोरिटी चाहिए एंड इन द पार्लियामेंट विद रेटिफिकेशन बट नॉट लेस देन द हाफ ऑफ द स्टेट्स. सो देर आर मेनी आर्टिकल्स इन द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन व्हिच मेंशन दैट दीज आर्टिकल्स कैन बी अमेंडेड बाय सिंपल मेजोरिटी सिंपल लॉ ऑफ द पार्लियामेंट. बट यहाँ पर देखिए व्हिच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग अमेंडमेंट जिसका एंड क्या है ना constitutional amendment aims to modify the an article related to the distribution of powers between central states and union government in which of the following types of majority is required to amend the constitution. The simple majority in the parliament and with ratification but not by not less than half of the states. Not it's correct. Special majority in the parliament with ratification but not less than half of the states. It's special majority, not simple. So special majority is important. There are three different ways of amending the Indian constitution. There are many articles in the constitution which I mentioned that these articles can be amended by a simple measure, simple law by parliament. No special procurements or to amend or amendment. So article under Article 368, no special procedure for amendment. Article 368 is required in such cases, and there is no difference at all between an amendment and an ordinary. Required in such cases, and there is no difference at all between an amendment and an ordinary law for amending the remaining parts of the constitution. Provisions has been made in Article 368 of the constitution. One method is that amendment can be made by special majority of the two houses of the parliament. Amendment to the constitution requires two different kinds of special majorities. So amendment to the constitution requires two different kinds of special majorities. In the first place, those voting in favor of the amendment bill should constitute at least half of the total strength of the house. Secondly, the supporters of the amendment bill must also constitute two-thirds of those who actually take part in votings. Another method requires special majority of the parliament and consent of half of the state legislature. Apart from the provisions related to federal structure, provisions about fundamental rights and are also protected in this way. Which of the following situation give rise to inflation? So when first is when general level of price of goods and services rises, it's correct. And second, when general level of price of goods is false, not correct. Yes, third, when purchasing power of the currency decreases. So it's correct. Four, when purchasing power of the currency increases. No, so one and three only correct. Inflation is the rate of which general level of price of goods and services is rising, and consequently the purchasing power of currency is falling. Consider the following statements about a cave at Badami. So 2 and 3. So you have a painting. The cave is popularly known as Indra Cave. So okay, but cave of Badami. Badami cave ko humne popularly kya jante na? Indra Cave. It's not correct. So And say second paintings in the cave represent the an extension of tradition from Ajanta caves. That's correct. Painting in this cave depict places scenes. So your Badami caves jo hai painting your painting in the cave represent the extension of tradition from Ajanta caves. And painting in the cave in this caves depict places palaces scenes. So 2 and 3 only correct. Statement 1 is incorrect. Statement 1 is incorrect. The inscription of in cave number 4, Badami Caves, describes the beauty of the cave and includes the dedication of the image of Vishnu. And so includes the dedication of the image of the Vishnu. This thus it may be presumed that the cave was excavated in the same era, and the patron records his Vaishnava affiliation. Therefore, the cave is popularly known as Vishnu Cave and not Indra Cave. It is popularly known as Vishnu Cave. Okay, and statement 2 is correct. And because painting in the cave represents the extension of tradition of from Ajanta caves. And statement 3, painting in the cave depicts palace scenes. 9, question number 9. Answer the following statements regarding the biodiversity hotspot. So first, a biodiversity hotspot is a biogeographic region that is both threatened with destruction and is a significant reservoir of biodiversity. So it is correct. So a biodiversity hotspot is a biogeographic region that is both significant reservoir and biodiversity and is threatened with destruction. And statement 2, the German biologist Ernst Haeckel coined the term biodiversity hotspot, is not correct. The term biodiversity hotspots specifically refers to 25 biogeographically. So it specifically refers to 25 biogeographically rich areas around the world that have lost at least 70% of their original habitat. The remaining natural habitat in these biodiversity hotspots around to just 1.54% of the land surface of the planet. Yet supports nearly 60% of the world's plant, bird, mammal, reptile and amphibian species live there. The British biologist Norman Myers called the term biodiversity hotspots. Biodiversity hotspots given by Norman Myers in 1998 as a biogeographic region characterized by both exceptional levels of plant endemism and by serious levels of habitat loss. So in 1988, Norman Myers, the word ecology also given by the German biologist Ernst Haeckel. 1869, Sir Arthur Tansley coined the term ecosystem. In 1935, ecology, Ernst Haeckel and Tansley, ecosystem. 1935. Last question, with reference to mitochondria, consider the following statement: they have their own DNA and ribosomes. It's correct. And second, they are storage sacks of solid and liquid content. It's not correct. With reference to mitochondria, so they have their own DNA and ribosomes. So mitochondria is also known as powerhouse of cells. The energy required for various chemical activities needed for life is released by mitochondria in the form of ATP, adenosine triphosphate molecules. ATP is also known as energy currency of the cell. The body uses energy stored in ATP for making new chemical compounds and for mechanical work. And mitochondria are strange orange organelles in the sense that they have their own DNA and ribosomes. Therefore, mitochondria are able to make some of their own proteins, vacuoles, and storages. Storage sacks for solid and liquid contents, and vacuoles are small sized in animal cells, while plant cells have very large vacuoles. So CRE1 is the correct. And second, they are storage sacs and of solid and liquid content. It's not correct. The mitochondria are able to make some of their own proteins, regulars, and storage sacs for solid and liquid contents. So statement one is only correct. So next we'll discuss another question. So thank you.